here's what I really think of Belgium.
Who will make the cut? Who in our hearts? MJT reviews.
I came to fight over you.
Mitchell James calling. Welcome back to MJT Reviews. Did you like that new jingle? Our theme song for MJT Reviews is co-written by myself and Elise Turner. She orchestrated the whole thing as a birthday present to moi. So I'm really excited. Thank you so much, Elise Turner, for everything you did with the jingle. And obviously I'm here to talk about Wake Up by Eliot. Wake up on a Saturday night. No one? No. Wake Up by Eliot was chosen internally, so there was no national selection in this instance. So it was just an internal selection by Belgium. So, woohoo! Let's continue. I'm going to dissect. For sure, this song starts off with a really brooding tone. It's just his voice. It's very brooding. Like, the music is really kind of taking us somewhere, you know, it's telling a story, it's raw, it's full of emotion. So straight away, you know what kind of tone you're getting with this song, and you're like, okay, serious time.
I woke up every night, I can find anyone to pray.
Okay, I'm gonna go on a journey with this song. J word, I'm going on a journey. I love Eliot's natural vibrato tone.
Somewhere in the
you know, he kind of is someone that can sing, like, when you hold a note, it ends on a, like, it holds on a vibrato. It could be hindrance. I'm sure he probably gets annoyed when he's like, oh, my bloody vibrato voice. But I think it's a unique tone to have, and I think ultimately it'll help you in life actually get ahead as a singer. Kelly Rowland has a really similar thing. His is not as quivery as Kelly Rowland, but he just has that vibrato as he holds a note. I heard that. I recognized it. I'm liking it. And it really suits this song as well. So it's a perfect match. If the song was written for him, was it? Yes or no? Then if it was written for him, whoever wrote this really wrote it for him well. Having said that, I don't feel like this song has anything that unique. For sure, I'd like to hear it on a radio station. For sure, I can hear it on adult contemporary. For sure, I could hear it on a perfect album. But for a song contest, when you're one of 41 countries trying to win us over, this song is super mellow. It's not a great start when there's already going to be songs like this, and it's not, it's just very, it kind of can be a little bit forgettable as the song goes. Although one thing that can save this is the chorus. I could hear, especially many young people could get into this song because of the chorus. It's just a hooky chorus. I came to fight over you. And I like the da 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 da. There's like accents. It's like, I came to fight over you.
I came to fight over you.
That's how I hear it, like da 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 da. It's kind of like a mix of like, kind of like a rocky song meets like a boys to men ballad in one, in like only a few bars, which is really cool, I must say. That's a really cool quality. It's probably the best quality in this song. And then I like how it does the same thing, but down like da 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 da. The middle section, I felt like this was bringing it to a moment. I was invested in this song. I listened to the verse, which was brooding. I listened to a hooky chorus. I listened to a brooding second verse. Listened to a hooky chorus. Then I get this middle section, which is like building up for a moment. I'm like, are we going to get a key change? Probably not. But we're getting something that's going to be incredible and, like, you know, wind machine worthy kind of thing. And so I'm expecting that moment, and then it goes into I came to fight. Silence, by the way. I came to fight over you.
I came to fight over you.
and it just went back to chill kind of chorus. Boys to Men vibe. I was disconnected from that moment because I was waiting for something great. I was waiting for that special moment at the end where he's gonna like riff into octave higher notes and there's gonna be like crazy instrumental, there's gonna be even like some kind of beat if you must, something that's going to attract us and kind of complete this emotional song. But it didn't. It just went back to this is how I was 30 seconds into the song is how I am now. So it went from like a 5, I would give it, and it went up to a 6, and then it went to a 5. No, thank you. So I was disappointed. I was really underwhelmed. I felt a little let down, and I disconnected. All I can remember is I can't fight over you, and I remember... Even the music video was done really well, how they had the box and the wars came out at that point. And when the wars and the box kind of fell apart, I was like, this is the moment. And then it was like, I came to fight over you. And I'm like, did the music video director get like a different memo? Because a different like demo recording? Because yeah, this wasn't representing musically what they were giving out visually as well. Or maybe they just knew that was the moment. It was building up to a letdown. So for that, I ain't fighting for you, Eliot. But like I said, great unique tone for sure. Hooky chorus, it's just a shame that they couldn't build it up. You need to build it up. You just need to build it up, okay? If it's going to be a non-album track, like if it's going to be a single in life, or if it's going to be, if I'm talking about mainstream single, or if it's going to be for a song contest, it has to have that huge build up to a great ending. And it just didn't, you know? Look at You Are the Only One from Sergei Lazarev, Russia 2016. That's an example of how you build up a last chorus. That's kind of what you need to do with this. Sure, you can say that's not his image. He's not that kind of guy. He's just a real chill, introverted singer. Well, it's not going to win you a song contest, okay? The concept of the music video I was digging, it reminded me of My Turn from Czech Republic in 2017. This moment, let me give to you what you give in to me. That's the least I can do. Not entirely, but somewhat. It kind of never changed the concept. Even though I liked that concept, the concept never changed. 3 minutes in, there's still these girls like lip syncing to him. And I was like, yeah. Nothing has changed. It all was just underwhelming ending. It's like they had a great 1 minute 30 written and they're like, how to end it? We can't end it. We have 2 hours until we have to submit the song or something, and they're like, let's just repeat everything and keep it in the same mood as well, because then we don't even have to add any kind of tempo change or anything like that. That's what I was getting. The thing is with this song is that it's just so vocally basic as well. I'm not sure. Maybe this is his vocal limit. Maybe his vocal limits are a few notes. But I would have loved in this song to see a vocal showcase. I want to hear where your vocal limits are.
The limit does not exist.
How low can you sing? How high can you sing? This entire song was in your mid-range. You were singing very comfortably, which as a critical point of view, it means you're playing it really safe. Either you just don't have the capacity to sing any higher or lower. In that case, you're not much of a singer. But I don't know if I believe that. I think you just wanted to go for something that was really comfortable and just really safe. You can say yes. It's a brooding song. Yes, great storyline. It took a risk. But did it really? It's a very vague risk. But once again, with these kind of entries. But yes, it had a great music video. Yes, it had... he has a great look. It's brooding. All that kind of stuff. But vocally, it was extremely safe. Without the message, you could put a song about Habibi. Habibi, Habibi. See, that song, which was called Habibi? Was it called Habibi? Habibi by Dolly Style. You probably don't even know what I'm talking about if you didn't watch Melody Festivalen. But they were, like, their message was so basic. But their song structure and melody and vocal was good. So, yeah, that's kind of something to go off with that. And also, even, I know Belgium likes brooding. I know City Limits. Was it called City Limits? City Limits by Blanche. Are you ready to take my hand? That was brooding, but the vocal range that she gave us was incredible. And it was still extremely timid. It was still very introverted, but she showed us an incredible range, an incredible dynamic. This song had no dynamic, except for that middle bit that had the dynamic ready to support something big, and then nothing big happened. So, what am I trying to say? Overall, to sum up, I don't hate this song. I don't think it's a bad song. I don't think it's a great song. I think it's a good song. And I think that is not going to win you anything in Eurovision. I don't know how this will go going into the final. I wish it all the best. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So, I'll be interested to see how it goes. Look, I loved last year's entry by Belgium. Just a matter of time. I suppose it's just a matter of time. Loved it. So, if that couldn't get through the final, I'm very curious about this one. Sure, I think he could get backed up by like a teen base, but